Gore District Council is in tatters with calls for Mayor Ben Bell to resign. New Zealand's youngest mayor was elected in October, but since then his term has been met with discord and controversy. Local Government Minister Kieran McInulty told us councils are responsible for resolving their own problems and at the moment statutory obligations are being met. He said if that changes, intervention will be considered. Logan Saul of the Young Elected Member Committee is backing the young mayor. He joins us now alongside Tracy Hicks, the town's former mayor. Mōrena kōrua, thank you so much for being with us.
Mōrena.
Logan, I'll get to you first, but I wanted to start with you, Tracy. What on earth is going on in Gore?
Oh, look, it's really unfortunate. This is a community that's known stability, particularly in local government, for a long, long time. And just to see see from the outside what's going on at the moment is not a good thing. So obviously there's a breakdown between the relationships, particularly between the mayor and the chief executive. But it's not a good look, and I'm disappointed that it's got to this point. And normally, and me being an ex-mayor, I wouldn't comment on this sort of thing at all, and I haven't for the last 6 months. But I've never seen this community as divided as it is right this minute, and I'm pretty keen to do whatever I can, whatever that might be, to make sure we get to a good transition for whatever is next. And from my perspective, I think there does need to be some intervention from government, and I understand what the minister is saying now, but it won't be long before they are starting to miss those crucial points, particularly around the annual plan and the long-term plan stuff that's going on. There's never been a more important time in local government than right this minute, and to make sure that we have a functioning council that's going to ensure productivity and consistency into the future is absolutely vital.
Yeah, although it seems at the moment, Tracy, like the council is not functioning. And a lot of that falls on the fact that from an outsider's perspective, it seems like a bunch of seasoned councillors not wanting to answer to someone in their 20s. Is that the case?
No, I don't think that's the case at all, actually. In fact, I think I know pretty much all of the... Well, I do know all the councillors are sitting around the table. I've got the utmost respect for them all. I don't agree with them all. They are people that have got a wide breadth of knowledge. They're people that have, they walk in all sorts of society in this community and understand what's going on. Absolutely, age, I don't believe, has got a thing to do with this.
Is Steve Parry, the CEO, is he a bully, Tracy?
Not in my view, absolutely not. He's a man that I've worked with for a long time, and we've had a pretty close professional relationship. We don't have a personal relationship at all. We've kept it very professional over the years. He's got an ability to do the job, and something that some people really struggle with is he's got the ability to make hard calls when they need to be made, and sometimes that doesn't go down well. But when you're employing a good number of people, and there's 100 plus people employed in the Gore District, then there's always going to be some disaffected, unfortunately.
Yes, although several sources told the Sunday team, who did a fantastic story last night about what's going on in Gore, several sources told that team that a number of former council staff had raised with you concerns over bullying allegations about Steve Parry, and that you hadn't acted on them, Tracy.
No, that's not correct. After they put that to me, I was racking my brain saying, who has talked to me over the years? And I like to think I've got a sort of an open door policy as a mayor, but I can only recall one person coming to me, an employee and her husband, and I took that at face value. And then when I saw the other side, I perhaps changed my view.
Although you would have seen the Sunday story last night, you would have seen those comments from Doug Walker, who's moved to the UK because of disputes that went on with Steve Parry at the council. He says Steve Parry turned up on his doorstep in the UK to get him to withdraw statements he'd made about his own alleged bullying. That's not on.
No, that's not one of Steve's best moments, I would have to say. I'm not sure what that was all about. I know that he was in the UK on other business at the time. But that wasn't a good one.
These are some of the comments that former multiple former council staff have made about Steve Parry. If you know more than him, do too well, you were bullied, intimidated out, one person said. The threshold is very low for being removed from your job, another person said. The CEO's style is divide and rule. How on earth is Ben Bell meant to do his job as an elected government official if this is the council he's a part of?
Okay, look, I don't know who you've been talking to, but I could come up with multiples of individuals who would say the opposite. So look, this is a he said, she said situation, and as I said before, really unfortunate for this community, which is a really strong and coherent community and doing some really good stuff.
So how do you move forward then? How do you move forward then, Tracy? Because clearly something needs to change.
Totally agree with you. Absolutely agree with you. And I think that there does need to be some intervention from outside. I don't know that the council can actually work through this one themselves. And, you know, I'd die in a ditch to protect democracy. But I think democracy needs protection from itself right at this present time. And having an intervention from central government, I think, is pretty important. Now, what that is could be a variety of things. And we've had examples of that over the years across the country. And I think there's at least a couple of places that are going through that at the moment.
It feels like such a shame, Tracy, because it feels like this could have been a golden opportunity, right? Mm-hmm. Someone with seasoned experience like Steve Parry working with a young, brilliant ideas man like Ben Bell. The two of them could have created something really special in that town, and yet here we are.
Yep. Yeah, here we are. That's right. So now we deal with it.
Yeah, the question becomes, how do you deal with it? 2,500 people have signed a change.org petition asking the CEO to resign. Do you think he should resign?
I wouldn't blame him if he did. Talk about him, the fire of public opinion. But personally, I don't think he should. I think that if there's some sort of investigation, intervention, that would indicate that something's gone wrong, then maybe you should. But there is quite a bit of uninformed comment going on, I would say. And that happens in every community. I come across multiple people, and over 20 years, I've had multiple people say to me, look, oh, this guy's got to go, he's not good. And I'd just say to them, have you met him? Have you talked to him? No, they haven't. So, going on hearsay can be a dangerous thing.
Former Gore Mayor Tracy Hicks joining us this morning. Thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it.
Good. Thank you.
Let's bring in Logan Saul now, the young elected member committee of Aotearoa. Mōrena. Is this pretty indicative of what it is like for young people trying to get into local body politics?
Look, I think we've seen similar cases across the country. Even myself personally have experienced it. But I think the difference there is a lot of our young elected members have had mentors to get them through this. It doesn't seem like Ben is getting that down there in Gore.
Yeah, it feels like he's a real island, like he's doing this on his own.
It sure does, and I guess that's taking a toll on his mental health. You know, he could have come in with these incredible, innovative solutions, but there's obviously some issues there that they need to get over.
One of the main criticisms of Ben Bell seems to be his communication. Is that a fair assessment, do you think? Is it reasonable that you would expect your mayor to have great communication skills?
Absolutely they have, but I mean, all my experiences and the experiences of our young elected member committee and working with Ben, the communication has been fantastic. So potentially maybe different in Gore, not sure.
Have you personally had contact with Ben Bell?
I absolutely have, and so have our other young elected members, just checking that he's okay, seeing how we can wrap around and support him, because it's a challenging role, and any role in public office can be really challenging.
How is he doing?
He's finding it tough, but, you know, good on him, Ben. He's still going hard. He still really wants to serve the community he was elected to represent.
It's a shame, right? Because at the end of the day, it's the ratepayers, it's the locals, the residents who suffer as a result of the infighting in a council like this. Yeah,
absolutely, and we've seen some things recently. So the vote of no confidence, it's purely symbolic. They cannot unelect the mayor. So all it does is kind of create that public division. What they need to do is proceed with an independent review, like they've already said they will, and do it with speed and then implement those recommendations. I don't think having government input or involving the minister is very helpful, especially at this stage when they need to actually look after themselves. They're staring down the barrel of commissioners at the moment, as Tracy mentioned earlier. So we can't have that. That's not tenable.
So how do you move forward then? Like, what's the best course of action here for both parties to ensure that we have a sustainable council here?
Look, I guess I would urge the councillors not to proceed with what they're going to tomorrow, which is the vote of no confidence, asking the minister to intervene and removing Ben from the committees. They need to go back to that independent review that they had commissioned, get that stood up, because it still hasn't been. And then as soon as those recommendations, that's a fact-finding mission. So when that comes out, all the facts will be available, and then they can make a decision based on that.
Logan Saul from the Young Elected Member Committee of Aotearoa New Zealand. Thank you for being with us this morning. No, really appreciate it. Mm.